Welcome. In this video, I'm going to show you how to perform a Wilcoxon signed rank test pairwise post-hoc test for a Friedman test, if you're still with me on that. So the Friedman test checks if there are any differences between multiple variables, and then we would like to know which ones are different, and some people recommend therefore using a pairwise Wilcoxon test. It's actually just performing the Wilcoxon test multiple times, which can be done by going to Analyze, and then Nonparametric Tests, and then Legacy Dialogues, and then two related samples. Then we need to move in each pair. So in my example, I was using 4.1 till 4.7. So click on one, then click Control for the other one, and then move it to the right. Click on one, Control for the other one, and again to the right, and you need to enter in this way each and every possible pair. So depending on how many variables you use, this might take a little bit of time, but okay, it has to be done. So I'm not sure if there's any faster way of doing this. It's also prone to error. Almost made one there myself, and let's see. I should in the end know luckily that I need 21, so I'm getting there. And then did I do the 4.3, 4.7, 4.4, 4.5, 4.5, 4.6, 4.4, 4.7, 4.5, 4.6, 4.5, 4.7, and the last one. And hopefully I then have in total 21. Nope, that means I forgot one. Really annoying. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 3, 4, 5. Here's one missing. 4.2 and 4.6. 4.2 and 4.6. Oh, 4.2, comma. 4.6. Now I should have 21. Make sure Wilcoxon is actually checked. If you like, under options, you could hit the descriptives. I don't need them. Click on OK, and in the output, you now get all the possible pairwise Wilcoxon tests. Scroll down, and all the way at the bottom, it should give me a nice one table with all the values. And I can see, for example, that this one seems to be significant. Now, these are not adjusted yet for multiple testing. So one approach for that is to use the Bonferroni correction, which is quite frequently used. There are plenty of other methods, but Bonferroni is quite often used. In that case, you would need more digits than just those three. You can double click on this table, and you should enter then the pivot tabling, and sometimes it does it within the output itself, but if it's a big table, it doesn't. And then if you double click on any of the values, you see you get more decimals. You can then copy paste that. So for example, if I would copy this one into Excel, for example, I have seven variables. That means my number of comparisons is, using this formula, 21. The significance I want to test is this one. Change the dot into a comma, O. I think my comma. And then the adjustment is simply this one multiplied by the number of tests that were actually done. So the adjusted significance would be 0.000126, and that would still be considered significant if you're using a 5% significance level. And that's how you can perform a pairwise Wilcoxon signed rank test after a Friedman test.